Hello! How are you doing? So, just had a nice pizza, load of chicken, some beer, and start out on Friday. Now I'm feeling some dessert. I've eaten the main course, I've had a little pasta, but now the dessert. I'm gonna go get it. So, hello again. Now, a thing about the world, we all enjoy at one point of our life to have cereal at night. One time, one of my friends from Ohio, Tom Shipman from Beer Drinkers United, sent me an honorary video. Basically, he did a beer review where he tipped beer into cereal and then proceeded to eat it. But moving on, over the years, people have put recycled things into beers like bread and spices and stuff. But now, the Seven Brothers Brewery have made beer with cereal. And probably three of the top cereals in the UK. From Kellogg's. So this one is the cast-off pale ale made with upcycled Kellogg's Rice Krispies, a double dry hot pale ale, weighing at 5.5%, sustainably produced with upcycled Kellogg's Rice Krispies. Lovely artwork on the can. Little description on the side. The other one is the Sling It Out Stout, made with upcycled Kellogg's Cocoa Pops. Cocoa Pops have started going through a rebranding along with modern cartoony work. This is a chocolate stout, still produced with upcycled Kellogg's Cocoa Pops. Let's look at it also. So it'd be, which is good if it holds up with all of them. Yeah. Oh, finally, this one is 5%. So it's a little bit lower in V compared to the other two. I was thinking that it was going to stick with the ABV mark of 5.5, or if they just stuck with the 5, but no. Anyway, so this is the Throwaway IPA made with upcycled Kells cornflakes. A hoppy IPA, stably produced with upcycled Kells cornflakes. Now, I remember seeing this a while back, them doing this, and I thought, oh, I'll never get to try them. And I went to Booth's in Ilkley here in West Yorkshire, and finally, I get to try these upcycled cereal beers. So, I suppose, time to drink. I'm going to go with straight away with the lowest ABV one, a hoppy IPA. I know the design, but the Throwaway IPA seems to be the similar design to the Sling It Out Stout, which I thought would have gone with the colour types of. I thought they'd gone with the almost similar color coding to the cereal itself. I mean, the cast-off pale ale has gone blue, which is the color of Rice Krispies. The Sling It Out Stout has gone brown with the color of Cocoa Pops. But for some reason, the Throwaway IPA with Kellogg's cornflakes it should have been yellow, branding repairs. Oh, maybe green. But it's gone blue brown as well. A darker brown. Yeah. So that's the throwaway IPA. Very hazy. Lemony golden colour. Tight white bubbles. This is the Sligo Hot Stout. To my knowledge, I think there's only three. I thought they would have done Frosties, in fairness, because that's another famous Kellogg's Cornflakes, Kellogg's brand. It's a bit sticky. The glasses are from Pilcro Beer Festival. They do a great beer festival called the Summer Beer Thing. I try and go every year if I can. Small to medium bubbles. It's not bad. But yeah, Seven Brothers is near the BBC studio in Manchester. Also near Booth's in Manchester. Call it Media City. And it's just around the corner. They do a beer club as well. I haven't been for a few years. So many places, so little time. But beer glass. Very dark in colour. Finally, Rice Krispies. Whenever I go to Wales, the standard was very. The IPA seem to be very alive. I always love the little cereal boxes when I go to the San Remo Hotel in Cardiff. Slight clear. It's a little bit more easy than the throat up here. But some throws are really good. I've always ever seen them available in booths. So I think there's a ball shop in Manchester, but I can't remember the name of it at the moment. But yeah. Lemony, tight white bubbles. So, Rice Krispies, Cocoa Pops, and Kettle Cornflakes. So, start off with Kettle Cornflakes. That's a nice beer. So, well placed. Not much to it in flavour and taste, but it's just very easy, enjoyable IPA, which is what Cornflakes is. So, in reference to the cereal that it's representing, it definitely delivers on both sides. Does it taste like cornflakes? I suppose to a certain degree, but does it taste like an IPA? So yeah, I think it wins on both, and it does. The one I'm looking forward to the most is the Cocoa Pops, because we all know what Cocoa Pops does. You put milk in, you put cereal in, it turns the milk into chocolate milk. There we go. Soft, elegant. Does taste like chocolate. Beer. This is what it's aiming for. And has done that. Does it all up to tasting like the cereal, get that reminiscence of the cereal. And a little bit, because when I hear of Cocoa Pops, it's like, Cocoa Pops is like Rice Krispies, but Rice Krispies keeps the milk. Milk. Cocoa Pops alters the milk to cocoa or chocolate. It does, it just tastes like cereal. And it's cool that they've done this. So, the Rice Krispies. I always had to, whenever I have Rice Krispies, I always had way too much sugar. So, if it is a really sweet beer, it would be really cool. It's a little more tropical on the aromas. That's nice. It's quite crazy this when you say, if you say something, you ultimately get the imagery in your head. Now, if you wave away the flavors of the cornflakes, the Cocoa Pops, or the Rice Krispies, you'll ultimately think, though they actually do taste like what it is. It does taste like cornflakes. If you hadn't told me, I would have said cornflakes. If you hadn't told me, Cocoa Pops. If you hadn't told me, Rice Krispies. But it's cool that they do taste like what they're representing. So, let's go on to the description part. A super pale ale brewed using upcycled Kellogg's Rice Krispies provided as part of their sustainability program, subtle bitterness of comments, the sweet notes from the cereal, and we've lashed a double dose of dry hop. Comet and Echo is one of my favorite up to the moment, and probably why I am leaning towards this beer. I did pick up some that I really liked in this beer, and now I know why. Giving lots of grapefruit, papaya, and such, definitely does. This is really tasty beer. Enterprise Center, Salford Keys, Manchester. But yeah, if you ever get a chance, get ride the tram down to the Mini City. Booths is a great place to in Mini City to buy local beers and such. And then if you stay long enough, the brewery opens, I think, after 5, I think. Sure. Been a while. So, the chocolate stout brewed using upcycled Kellogg's Cocoa Pops. Getting ahead of myself. Sustainable program, base malt, chocolate malt, caramel malt, and of course Kellogg's Cocoa Pops make up the backbone of this thick, sweet and chocolatey stout. All these malts are mashed in at the high temperature to capture the sweetness and texture of the grain. And I'm still tasting that, even though I had the cast off. Such good beers. The final one, the cornflakes. A hoppy IPA brewed using upcycled Kellogg's cornflakes provided as part of the sustainability program. A deep orange hue with a plenty of residual sweetness. Fry hops with Crystal, Utica, and Falcon's Flight. If you're going to name it hot, why not call it Falcon's Flight? For an aroma and profile. People have come to expect from a modern IPA, so it's a modern IPA. It is a great, enjoyable IPA. But if I was to choose, and they're all good cereal in their own right, but if I choose one that I enjoyed the most out of the three, would be the Castor. Because, like I said, Equinox, There was something about this I really enjoyed, but I didn't know what it was until I read the description and I realised, it's definitely not my favourite hop at the moment. But they all taste like their respective cereals. And it's pretty cool that they upcycled these cereals to show that even though something's on the way out, you can still make it on the way in. And they've made this pretty great tasting beers. Would I buy these again? Hell yes, if I had a chance. But it's not every time I get to go to Manchester or Ilkley. So I hope Seven Brothers do get better, because I've managed to chat to them a few times when I went to the brewery, and really nice people, and their sisters and family get involved with the brewery. So if you get a chance, definitely recommend visiting the brewery, definitely recommend visiting booths in Manchester or Ilkley. Until next time, enjoy these beers, relax. You take care. Goodbye.